Alright guys, welcome back. Mems here from Trinity's Evolution, and we've got a special car inside here, guys. We've been building it over for a year now. It's one color. It's not all over the place, and we can't wait to show you guys. It's all covered up inside, and let's just open the door and show you guys. But before we get there, make sure you follow me on Instagram and TikTok. You guys would have seen it from there already. If you guys don't follow me, please go there. It'll be down here and in the description. Make sure you subscribe as well, because it just motivates me more to push out more videos. Can't wait to show you guys this car. It's just inside. It's been a long journey. It's just been a very long journey. I've got the car socials in the description as well, if you want to stay tuned and follow for that car as well. All right guys, no more talking, no more blathering about. Let's get straight to the point. All right, let's go. Follow me, guys. Alright guys, we're inside. Here's the car. As you guys can see, it's all wrapped up, all covered up. Just excited, as I said before, outside. The car is one color. It's not all over the place. Look at the car, guys. It just looks like a race car at the moment. Like, looks all crazy. The whole body kit is on. The spoiler's on, as you guys can see from there as well. Got some aftermarket rims as well, but we're gonna go something else in the future. Can't wait to show you guys. Look, Sylvia. Chef? Should I open it?
Yeah.
Yeah? Should I open it?
I don't know, should you?
Should I open it, guys?
Just leave it like this.
Leave it like this, huh?
Yeah.
That's the end of the video. Make sure you subscribe. No, I'm joking. Let's go. Ready? Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you stay tuned. Here it is. Horizon got that sauce, boy. As you guys can see, the R34 is here, and if you guys are wondering what the color is called, it's called Silver Flake, and in my opinion, it just looks amazing. It looks nice, especially with the R34 GDR body kit, Z-Tune. The whole body kit is on, the spoiler, side skirts, everything is on. In my opinion, just the front end, when you guys look, like, it just looks mean, you know? When you look at it, because of the headlights, they're all being refreshed, everything is just brand new, and then the intercooler as well, it just looks amazing in that front end. Yeah, the whole windows are all in. These fenders just look amazing over here. We still gotta get these indicators in. We're probably gonna go smoked, I don't know. Custom made a mesh for this Z-Tune style fender. In my opinion, it just looks amazing. It looks better than what it was. Mirrors are all in. The door card's not in yet. The interior we haven't touched yet. That'll be a separate video for you guys. As you guys can see, the side skirt, they're pretty much on. Yes, these used to be two-piece. In my old video, a couple videos back, you guys would have seen that. And we've made it one piece, as you guys can see, and the extension is on as well. Chef just didn't like the two-piece look, and yeah, he actually did a really good job making this one piece. Looks amazing, looks better. So we've got these fender flares here, as you guys can see. When I first saw these, I was like, these are gonna look ugly, these are gonna look really bad, but now I'm looking at them and it just suits the whole body kit. It just looks like a GDR now, you know? You know how people like roll their fenders? It just looks like that. But this is just way more cleaner, way more nicer. Three quarters, we were gonna make it, you know how the GDR is. We've done the whole front end and everything, the whole GDR is, as you guys can see, it's a full wide body, pretty much on the front end. That's how the Z-Tunes come. And we were gonna do the rear quarters, but we just didn't want to ruin the car. We didn't want to break the originality. And yeah, we just left it. But to make it look like a GDR, we did put these flares on, and just to make it look wider. And in my opinion, it actually turned out really, really well and really, really good. So yeah, as you guys can see, the whole car is just, it just speaks for itself, to be honest. Like the whole look, move to the back, right? Even from the back end, guys, from the tail lights and everything, you guys can just see the fender flares. It looks better than stock body, basically. And when you get to the back, guys, the back just shows a lot. But as you guys can see, we've got this carbon fiber wing from Carbonetics. Yeah, it's not everyone's taste for the R34, but the style that we're going for, we had to use this wing. You guys know, you should stay tuned, because there's gonna be way more stuff doing to this car. We still haven't done the interior. And we still haven't done a lot of more stuff to this car.
Yes.
So the rear bumper's on, guys, and the rear pods, and the exhaust needs a bit of adjusting. As you guys can see, it sits a bit to the left. We want it to sit right in the middle, but the exhaust, guys, high power tune. If you guys would have seen the tuning video from Team Kurum, shout out to them, the whole thing. And yeah, the exhaust just looks amazing. HKS exhaust, can't go bad, can't go wrong. The front end, guys, just makes me go crazy, guys. Even the back end, if you, like, when you look at the car, you just know it's an iconic car. Like, just these taillights here, when people see it, they go crazy. I don't know why, but they just go crazy. As you guys can see, this part's a bit empty. No number plate, no brake light, and no reverse light. We're still gonna get those stuff. And that's pretty much from the back. When the blue stuff go on, you know, I just wanna give it a little hint. It's gonna look good. All right, guys, so on that side is basically the same thing on this side, you know, it's the same, you know, sides. You can't really make anything different. We put the rear wiper on, that's painted and all coated. Rear wiper's on, and we put all these rubbers on as well, guys. It's been all put together. We're gonna get new ones of these, probably gonna get Nismo ones. This one just came out really bad. Front windshield and the rubbers here as well, guys, are all they're all done as well, and the wipers at the front. I got these from online, from like a special store. It's like a it's like a special deal, like a car. It's just for like special cars, like a show car basically. And I had to buy those. Still got the stock mirrors. Buy the mirrors inside, as you guys can see. Very exciting. We put our new dash in, and yeah, I'll just show you guys right now. All right, guys, this is the interior. We've got the whole dash in, guys, as you guys can see. This is a brand new dash. No cracks, no nothing, everything is brand new. These gauges place is gonna go, and we're gonna get a full Haltech screen for it. Steering wheel is gonna go, we've got it at home. Seen it in one of my videos, guys. If you know, you know. Whole center console and everything here is gonna change. Everything's gonna be custom. We did put the headliner, guys. As you guys know, the R34 GTT, they come cream, but now this, everything is all blacked out. For these and this part, we're gonna get them all custom made, basically make it look better. And there's no floor mats, no nothing. We're gonna do soundproofing to it on its way. And yeah, the whole interior is like that. We still gotta buy new seats for it. Waiting for car parts, guys. We've been waiting for this car for so long to be done. All cards are not done yet, but as you guys can see, the hole where the door sits, all the rubbers and plastics are in, where it writes Skyline as well. And yeah, the door insides are just looking amazing, looking really good, matching the whole car. We can't wait to put the cards in as well. Yeah, everything is just time and place, guys, so we just gotta wait for parts. Let's move to the engine bay. Here's the engine bay. Alright, guys, as you guys know, I've shown this engine bay a lot. It's been everywhere on TikTok, Instagram, you name it, it's been everywhere. Just added this carbon fiber look, radiator cover, basically just for looks. It looks mad. We did a custom job. So when we bought this body kit, we wanted, of course, to make everything look nice and make everything look, you know, proper. This is not an original body kit. It's a fiberglass bonnet. Every time we tried to close it, it would touch. As you guys can see, we've left a mark here, and we're gonna fix that up later. So what did we do? We had to cut this piece for the bonnet to sit properly, to line up properly as well with this, and just to sit properly. As you guys can see, we cut it, but it comes like here, even on this side as well, on the same, comes like that. But what we did was we had to cut it so the bonnet can sit properly and it doesn't touch over here, because this this piece over here, right here where we cut, used to touch here, and basically the same thing on this side. So we cut it, we made a custom made radiator support, I don't know what you guys call this, but a cover, make it look nice basically. There is a bonus, you get to take out the headlight without removing this as well. Yeah, this is like a little custom thing we did. In my opinion, it just looks nice, looks mad, looks proper. Other than that, guys, so the engine's basically the same as you guys would have seen in my last videos, the RB25 Neo. And then we've got the turbo high mount setup. So the turbo is a Garrett 3076. Pretty big turbo, it's pretty laggy, but it's all right. This pipe, it goes crazy. The dose is crazy. Exhaust manifold as well, it just sounds amazing. It sounds basically the same as the movie car. It's crazy how it just sounds the same. Our downpipe is a 3-inch all the way down to a 3.5 exhaust, cat-back exhaust, the HKS exhaust I already showed you guys. On our other side here, our race tune intake manifold connected to our intercooler. Hey guys, that's basically the whole setup here. Car makes 300 kilowatt, so 400 horsepower. You know, 400 horsepower to the road is crazy with these cars. Because the body is such a light chassis, it just goes crazy. This one flex fuel, E85 and 98, so we can change wherever we want. We've got a Haltech Platinum Pro plugged in as well. We can change our tune anytime we want. And that's basically it for this engine, guys. Get your plans for it. We'll probably put cams in it. We'll probably build the inside in the future. But for now, guys, it's perfect. All we need to do, guys, is basically clean it up. It's a bit messy. We've got a fuel pressure regulator over here as well. Forgot to tell you guys. And we've got a custom catch can as well over here that goes for extra oil. Yeah, that's basically it, guys. You know what? I'll give you guys a little sneak peek. Let's hear it. So I'm going to pull out the car so you guys can hear. The timing belt is a bit tight. We just got to loosen it. That's why there's a noise there. But we're going to take out the car and I'll show you guys how it sounds. So we just pulled out the car, E85, if you guys know, we just got to warm up the car for a bit. We don't want to rev it while it's not warm. When it's warm, we'll rev it, guys. So the car is a bit warm. We're warming it up, as you guys can see. And first I'll give you an exhaust note and then I'll give you the front end. Yeah, I'll just go rev it for you guys. That's what I heard, the exhaust. Now it's the, let's hear the front, let's hear the dose. Let's put this car back inside.
The whole interior
is nearly done, and I just put the car back inside, and I just can't wait to do this whole thing, as you guys can see. But please stay tuned, like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next episode. Peace. I love you all. Horizon got that sauce, boy.